Hello everyone, today we are going to do class 9th, Maths, Chapter 10, Bank and Simple Interest, practice set number 4.1. Other questions from this exercise are being solved. The link will be provided in the description box, you all can check it. The remaining sums are going to be solved today. Okay, so let's start. When principal is been given 25,000 rupees, amount is 31,000 rupees, time is 4 years, what is the rate of interest? Okay, so for this, first we have to find the amount. Minus principal is equal to total interest. Okay, so this is the formula for total interest, that is amount minus principal. So amount is how much, children? This is the amount. So 31,000 minus principal is 25,000, so 25,000, the total is going to be, the subtraction is going to be 6,000. Okay, so we have got our total interest now. Now the principal is 25,000 rupees, time is 4 years, and interest is 6,000 rupees. Okay, children, is it clear now? First we have found the interest, okay, and the formula is amount minus principal. Now we have to find simple interest. Okay, so simple interest is going to be P into R into T upon 100. Okay, so what is the simple interest we have? That is 6,000 rupees. Okay, P is 25,000 rupees, R is, we have to find it, and T is 4 upon 100. Okay, so R is equal to 6,000 multiplied by 100 upon 25,000 into 4. Okay, so when you solve these operations, when you solve this, children, you are going to get your R is equal to 6. I hope you will all be able to solve this operation. It is very easy. So, therefore, the rate of interest is 6PCPA. Okay, is it clear? This type of sums are going to be solved in this exercise. Okay, let's move to the next question. That is, Umesh borrowed some money for 5 years at simple interest. The rate of interest is 9 PCPA. The return, if he returned 17,400 rupees altogether at the end of 5 years, how much he borrowed? Okay, so over here, interest, that is I, is equal to P into R into T, okay, upon 100. This is the formula as we did for the first sum also. Now this formula cannot be directly solved because we do not have either interest or principal. Okay, we are not having the interest also and the principal is also not there. So first what we have to do, we have to either find an interest or a principal. So how are you going to find? See, the interest on the principal of 100 rupees for 5 years is 45 rupees. Okay, so this is the answer that you all have to calculate. Okay, so what we have calculated is that the interest on a principal, we will write it down so that the confusion will not be there. On a principal of 100 rupees for 5 years is 45 rupees. Okay, when you do these calculations, you will be getting this answer. So the amount is going to be 100 plus 45, that is 145 rupees. Now we are having the amount, children, so we can calculate the further operations. So let, if Umesh principal is P, then P upon 17,400 is equal to 100 upon 145. Okay, therefore P टी इज इक्वल टू 100 इंटू 1740 अपॉन 145. व्हेन यू डू द फॉलोइंग ऑपरेशन यू आर गोइंग टू गेट द आंसर एज 12,000. ओके, सो द प्रिंसिपल, देयरफॉर द प्रिंसिपल दैट उन्मेष borrowed was 12,000 rupees. Okay, is it clear? Now, these were the solved example from the textbook, children. You all can solve, you all can check it from the textbook also if you all haven't understood. And if there is any queries, please let me know in the comment section. Now, let's move to the problem sum fourth. Okay, so this is the sum from the problems practice set number 41. First, second and third is already been completed in the last video. The link will be provided. So, today we are going to solve the fourth sum. So, Lata Behen borrowed some money from a bank at a rate of 10 PCPA interest for 2.5 years to start a cottage industry. If she paid 10,250 rupees as a total interest, how much money had she borrowed? Okay. So, let's start with the solution. I is going to be I2. Okay, so this is going to be rupees 10,250 rupees. R is going to be 10 PCPA. T is going to be 2.5 years. And P2 is going to be question mark. Now, let the principal be rupees 100. Okay, let principal be rupees 100. Okay, now why we are taking 100 rupees, children? Because we are not knowing the principal, that is why we are taking it rupees 100. So this is going to be a P1. Okay, P2 we need to find, P1 we have assumed it and taken it as 100. So I is equal to P into R into T upon 100, where P we have supposed it as 100 into 10 into 2.5 upon 100. Okay, so this 100 and this 100 is going to get reduced. What is going to remain is 10 into 2 upon 2.5. Okay, so first we will reduce, do the calculation. That is 2 2 is 4 4 plus 1, that is going to be 5. So this is going to be 10 into 5 upon 2. Okay, so 2 ones are 2 fives are 5 fives are 25. Okay, now what is this, children? We have got the interest. What we have got? We have got the interest on 100 rupees. Clear? So I on, or you all can write it in full form, I on principal 100 rupees, 100 is rupees 25. This is I1. I hope you all have understood, children. This is what we have assumed it. Okay? From the 100 rupees. Because we are not having the principal. But R we have taken from the question. T is also from the question. Okay? So, over here we have received I. Now, I1 upon I2 is equal to P1 upon P2. Got it? So, I is how much? I1 is how much? 25 upon I2 is how much? We have, it has been already given, that is 10,250. So, 250 is equal to P1, what we have assumed? 100 rupees. And P2, we need to find it. Now, what we have to do is cross multiply it. Okay, so after cross multiplying, you will be getting 25 into P2 is equal to 100 into 10,250. Is it clear, children? Therefore, P2 is going to be how much? 100 into 10,250 upon 25. Is it clear? Now, when you solve these operations, you are going to get your answer as 41,000. So, we have got our principal, children. That is, Lata Behen had borrowed rupees 41,000. Is it clear to everyone? It is very easy, some children. Only the steps you all have to remember, and the same you all have to keep on solving it. The same type of formula is there. Only two type of pattern is been given in this exercise. Now, excuse me. Let's solve the next question. Now, this is question number 5. Fill in the blanks in the table below. You all can refer the textbook, children. The first sum is principal rupees 4,200. R is 7. PC, PA. T is 3 years. We have to find I, that is interest, and A, that is amount. So first I, P into R into T upon 100 is going to be 4200 into 7 into 3. We have to only substitute the values. Upon 100, these two zeros are going to get reduced. Multiply these three, you are going to get rupees 882. Okay, now A is equal to P plus I, that is what is, how much is P? Rupees 4,200. And how much is I? 882. When you add this, you will be getting 5082. Clear? Next sum. P is equal to question mark. We have to find P. R is 6 PC, PA. T is 4 years. I is rupees 1,200. A is question mark. Okay, so this is the information that they have given in the question. So I, P into R into T upon 100, where I is, therefore I is 1,200. P into 6 into 4 upon 100. Okay, therefore P is equal to 1200 into 100, 6 into 4. Got it? So when you do the operation, children, see 6 ones are 6, 2s are 12, 4 ones are 4, 5s are 20. So 50 into 100, you are going to get your answer as rupees 5000. So what is this? This was the P. And then A is equal to P plus I, that is rupees 5000 plus 1200, so rupees 6200. Clear? Now the third sum, P is rupees 8000. R is equal to 5 PC, PA. T is equal to question mark, we need to find the T. I is equal to rupees 800. A is equal to question mark. So we need to find T and A over here. Same formula. You will see that we are using the same pattern, same formula all over. Only the values of different things we are finding. Therefore, I is, excuse me for that. I is how much? 800. Is equal to P is 8000 into 5 into N. Okay, upon 100. Okay, so N is going to be 800 into 100 upon 8000 into 5. So these two zero cut, these two zero cut, one zero cut from here, one zero cut from here, 5 ones are, 5 twos are, 8 ones are, 8 ones are. Okay, so you will see that we have left with only 2 years. Excuse me for that horn, children. So A is equal to P plus I, that is rupees 8000 plus 800 is going to be rupees 8800. Clear? Now fourth sum is P is equal to question mark. R is equal to 5 PC, PA. T is equal to question mark. I is rupees 6000. A is equal to rupees 18,000. Okay. So first we will find the principal over here, because we are not having the principal, so we won't be able to use this formula over here. So first what we have to find? Principal. And how are you going to find the principal? That is amount P plus interest. So amount is 18,000 is equal to P plus 600. Therefore amount is 18,000, P as it is, and I is 6,000 rupees is our I. Got it? Excuse me. Now let's do the next step. Therefore, P is equal to rupees 18,000 minus 6,000 is going to be rupees 12,000. So I is equal to P into R into T upon 100. Therefore, 6,000 is equal to 12,000 into 5 into T upon 100. So T is equal to 6,000 into 100. 12,000 into 5. So when you reduce this, you are going to get your T is equal to 10 years. P is equal to question mark, R is equal to 2.5, PCPA, T is equal to 5 years, I, excuse me, I is equal to rupees 2400, A is equal to question mark. So I is equal to P into R into T upon 100. I is 2400. I have substituted the value. Into 100 upon 2.5 into 5. Okay. So 2.5 is going to change to 100 into 2. 5 into 5. Okay. 2 2's are 4. 4 plus 1 is going to be 5. So this is going to be 5 upon 2 children. So this 2 will move to upward and 5 will remain over here. So this is not, you all don't have to write this. This is for your explanation. So do this following operation. After solving this operation, you will be getting your P is equal to rupees 19,200. Now remaining A, P plus I is equal to rupees plus 2400 rupees 21,600. Okay, now these sums are very easy children over here. Our exercise 41 is over and the lesson is also over, bank and simple interest. If there is any queries, please let me know in the comment section. I will try to solve your queries. Okay, see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.